Everyone in every section, everyone in the hallways, come on in. Hallelujah. Come on into the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. If you are glad to be here today, why don't you clap your hands to the Lord? Why don't you lift up your voice in praise and adoration to the King of Kings and to the Lord of Lords? Praise God. Hallelujah, Jesus, we love you. Why don't you shout unto God with a voice of triumph? Hallelujah, you are great, Lord, and greatly to be praised today. We have come to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We have come to give him everything that he deserves today. It's a great day. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Who's going to rejoice today? Who's going to rejoice in the Lord today that he woke you this morning, that he's kept you this week, and that he's been good to you through it all? Praise God. Hallelujah. Our children's choir is going to come up in just a minute, and they're going to sing. Why don't we get behind them and why don't we worship the Lord? Today is a day of worship and of praise. I'm excited about what they're fixing to do. They're going to sing a couple of songs and then our choir is going to sing. So why don't you worship the Lord today? Give God everything you've got. Hallelujah, for he alone is worthy. Praise God. Let's give them a big hand. Hallelujah. Don't we love our children? Amen. Don't we love our children? Praise God. Fine looking bunch. Hallelujah. I'm going to turn it over to Sister Underwood.
Praise the Lord, everybody. These children have worked so hard. They're so excited to be able to present this to you all today. So just get behind them. If you know the song, sing with them and give glory to the Lamb. You can be seated. Thank you.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, I know we got a lot of proud parents out there. And if it's any indication on how proud you are, my wife was tearing up over there, and Nora's not even up here yet. So you should be proud. Amen. Our children are learning to worship the King. Our children are learning to do what is important. They're learning to have a relationship. They're learning to walk with Jesus. They're learning who Jesus is. They're learning for the real reason for the season, right? Amen. We are going to enter a time of transition here in our service as we get ready for our worship department to come. And while they are getting ready, if we could have our ushers come up, we're going to go ahead and take up our offering. So if y'all would stand with me. Amen. This is our weekly tithes and our offering that we are going to take up at this time. Praise the Lord. The Lord loves a cheerful giver, so let's be cheerful. Amen. If you can't be cheerful at any other time of the year, this is the time of year when you should be cheerful. Praise the Lord. Why don't we go before the Lord in prayer? Lord Jesus, we thank you for your Spirit. We thank you for what you're doing here. We thank you for our children, oh God. We thank you for what they're doing in what you're doing in their lives, oh Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for what you're going to do here today. Father, we thank you for your Spirit and your presence that we feel so strong in this place. We thank you for your word, oh Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for this offering. We ask you to bless it, multiply it for your kingdom, for your purpose, oh God. To you be all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. We thank you, Jesus. You are holy, you are mighty, you are righteous, oh God, and we worship you. In your precious name we pray. Amen. Amen. If you would bring your offering from all sides, go ahead and put that in the baskets. And while you are bringing your offering, if you would pay attention with me for just a moment. two very important people that are here today that we would like to take a moment just to recognize. How many of you are thankful for our pastor and his wife? Pastor and Sister Hunt do a lot for the church, and they do a lot without asking for anything in return. And so, Pastor, Sister Hunt, the church has gotten these together for you, and the school, Sister Hunt, for you as well. And we would like you to take these as a token of our appreciation, our love for you. We want y'all to know we love you and we appreciate you.
Amen. Thank you, church. I appreciate you. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. You said, Brother, it ain't Christmas yet, but it's almost here. And I know that it's hard to get us all together at Christmas. We've had several Christmas banquets already. We're doing small group banquets this year. Instead of the whole church at one time, we're trying to keep it separated. So every group has had we still got two left. Tonight at 6:30 is our men's banquet. Make sure you stop by the table and get your ticket for the men's banquet. We're excited about that, having catfish and barbecue. Woo, come on, let me hear amen on that. Amen. It's important to be a part of your church, so make sure you entertain yourself with one of these banquets. We've had several already, but we have the men's banquet tonight at 6:30. The young marrieds is when? Friday night at what? All marrieds. At what time? 6:30 next Friday, so make sure you put that down, guys. We need you to be here. It's going to be a good time of celebration. You can be seated for a minute. Everybody say, it's Christmas. Get excited about it. It's Christmas. It's time to join in. And we got a lot going on, and I know you're busy, folks, but today I want to recognize a few people that I love dearly that God has helped me. I asked God a long time ago. I said, God, send me some help that are on fire for you, that don't mind working, and it's not a drag, and they're always excited. And we have that team today, and I want to recognize our staff, our immediate staff today. And we're going to give other gift cards out later, but I want to recognize our immediate staff today. And one of them is our family pastor, Brother and Sister Norris. Would you guys come? Let's give Brother and Sister Norris a hand. Thank you, guys. Stand up here behind me if you would. Brother and Sister Norris is a blessing to CFPC. They have taken the young marriage to another level. I'm telling you, if you're not a part of this young marriage class, you need to be, because they will either, you'll either leave his class crying or wanting to do better, praise God, or feel good, because he has got some good thoughts to give. And sometimes you do leave and think, oh, man, that's tough, but that's right. Thank you guys for standing for the truth. All right, Brother and Sister Bishop, our assistant pastor, would you guys come? Brother and Sister Bishop and little Nora. She recognized me as pastor, so I'm glad they're a part of the team as well. Doing a great job. Brother Bishop takes care of everything that I can't take care of, pretty much. I appreciate you for all your work and dedication to the kingdom of God. We have another couple here today, Brother and Sister Underwood, that lead all those children you see here today. These are probably one of the toughest ministry in the church, but they do their part because they love kids, and it's amazing what they do with the Lord. And Brother Stephen is probably with the kids. He's probably rounding the kids up right now. And we're thankful for that. I mean, it's a ministry, children's ministry. And if anybody else wants to be a help in the children's ministry, just see her. I promise you, she's got a list this long she can have help with. And we would love for you to do that. And also, we have another worship pastor here, Brother Brent Edwards. Where are you at, my brother? Love him. Thank you, Brother Edwards, for your dedication to the kingdom of God. And this is the staff that we have gotten together and put together. And I got one more that I'm going to tell you that has become so much help to Sister Hunt and I that it's just amazing. All these guys are help, because it's one thing we don't have to worry about doing. I promise you, every one of these groups right here, I don't have to never say, hey, you got children's church ready? Hey, you got something? You got the internet thing going? Everything's ready? You got service lined up? Hey, are you guys all right? Families, y'all, everything? I don't ever have to worry about it. Brother Brent, is what you singing today? Well, let me check you out. I don't never have to do that because they're right on target. They've taken that load off of us. But this next lady, Regina Blanton, where'd she go? There she is. Sister Regina Blanton is ours. And I want to say something. Sister Regina is my secretary. She's really not the church secretary, but she's my secretary, okay? So she makes copies for me. She does things for me, and she will help you too. But I'm so thankful the load that she's taking off of Sister Hunt and I. Again, let's give her a hand again. Thank you, Sister Regina, for being. Let's give our staff, all of them, one more good hand clap. Thank you, guys. Merry Christmas, and hope the Lord bless you guys today for helping us here at CFPC. Hallelujah. I tell you something else I like about our staff. I can disagree with them, get in the office, get staff meetings, and we just pretty much hash it out between one another, and we say, you know what, let's go worship now. Because we're not here to worship one another. We're here to worship God. We're here to give Him the praise, give Him the glory. We don't see eye to eye on everything, but yet still we do know that Jesus is our Savior. He was born as our Savior. Hallelujah. He's a deliverer. He's a healer. He's a way maker. Hey, my friend, if we can agree on those things, we will have church when we get together. And thank you. There's so many others, so many more we're going to recognize next Sunday for helping out. This thing don't just happen by itself. The sound just didn't come on by itself. The lights just didn't come on by themselves today. There's so much we can give gratification for, and we will do some more of that next week. But we want to get right into our Christmas program. But I do have one more thing that I want to do today. Last Sunday, I told you we was going to take up a special offering. And this is going to help some people that are in need. I know as pastor, some people that are in need today, and I want us to give. I tell you what I do, and I don't have this to give. I need to put it somewhere else. But I tell you what, I do it by example today, okay? I'm going to reach in here and get the biggest bill I got. It's a $100 bill. I give the first $100 bill to this needy Christmas family today. And if you'll follow suit, I'm not saying give 100, but just give what you can to this today. I promise you, if you want to give cash, you can. If you want to write a check, it'll go for, you can use it against your, for your taxes or whatever. But we're going to use every penny of this to help some people in Christmas this year. And it's also going to help our Christmas for Christ, which we help every year. We do a Christmas Christ for offering for needy families that are in missions and our small mission churches, home mission churches that don't have a whole lot to handle. So give what you can today. If you want to give on the app today, you can do that. Just put under the bottom a special offering for Christmas, and we'll know where that offering goes in the memo of that on the app that you give on today. We need everybody to help give in this offering. This is going to be a blessing to somebody to be able to have Christmas this year, okay? So be sure you help us out today, and if you can be a blessing for it, we would love you and appreciate you for it today. And as we pray, you just bring your offering one more time, and our choir is going to get ready. Don't the choir look good today? My Lord, look at those blue ties. Let's give our choir a hand. Boy, y'all looking good. They as well has put hours in their practicing. They've come early. The sound people came early to help them, and it's just been amazing. I love our choir. I love what Brother Brent has put together here today. I watched pieces of it, but I haven't saw the whole thing, so I'm excited. Bring your offering. That's good. Bring it and be a blessing for somebody today. In the name of Jesus, God, bless this service. Have your way today, God. I pray your presence as they sing to the glory of God. Let the glory of the Holy Ghost just fill this house. Let all hearts be blessed. Let every person under the sound of my voice feel your presence today. God, this is about you. We come today to worship you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ today. If you're waiting for a sermon, you're about to hear the sermon. I want you to worship as our choir comes. God bless.
Amen. Before we begin our program, can we just all stand together and just sing a familiar hymn? Amen. Joy to the world.
Joy to the world, the Lord.
Joy. together and thank the Lord for it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Turn to your neighbor and say, I've got joy. Turn to your other neighbor and say, I've got joy. Amen. You can be seated in the presence of the Lord. Before we begin today, I just want to give thanks. I know we've been thanking people today, and I want to take this opportunity to do that. Appreciate Pastor and Sister Hunt for allowing us this opportunity to minister to you in this way. We haven't had choir for a lot of the year because of the things that have been going on, but a few weeks ago we decided to start the choir back up and decided we could at least squeeze in some sort of Christmas program. And how many are thankful to see the choir back up here? Amen. Amen. And so I do want to thank all of our singers and musicians. They put in work throughout the year. We worked together for several years. And as Pastor has said, this doesn't just happen. People have to sacrifice. They have to give up their time with their families and other things. And so I appreciate each of you very much. I want to tell you all that right here in front of the whole church. I love you all. It's a pleasure to work with you. Amen. Give them one more hand of applause. And we could not do what we do without a very special team of people, and that is our sound and media team up at the top. And I probably shouldn't call names, but I do want to give special thanks, especially to Brother and Sister Pope, who are up there today, and also Brother and Sister Manning and Sammy Shackelford. They get a day off today. But these four people are up there, seems like just about every other service, and we appreciate you all very much. You as a church can imagine, I was thinking about it today, what would it be like if we didn't have the sound and the lights and the screens and the words, all of that. Sound and media is kind of like electricity. You don't really think about it until something quits working. You go to flip the switch on and the light doesn't come on and something's not working. And so we want our sound and media team to know that we do appreciate all the work that you do. This church is blessed. One more time, would you give them a hand clap? And last, as we transition to our program, I want to just give the Lord thanks because He is the reason that we're here today. He is the reason that we celebrate. He has been so good to us. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The title of our program today is Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Today we are celebrating the birth of our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, whom Revelation 13 and verse 8 calls the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. Are you thankful that before we were ever born, God had a plan of redemption in mind? He was the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world, and we've come to give Him glory today. And we understand today that this Jesus that we're singing about, that we worship, He was the prophesied Messiah to the nation of Israel. Prophecies about Him are scattered throughout the Old Testament. One of the most famous of these is found in Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14, which says, "Therefore the Lord Himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call His name Emmanuel." Can we just say Emmanuel today? That means God with us. So this first song that we're going to sing today is an ancient hymn that dates back some 1,200 years. We call it, O Come, Emmanuel. This song describes the longing of Israel for their promised Messiah, because they were told in Haggai chapter 2, verse 7, that the desire of all nations shall come. That Messiah, he's the desire of all nations. He shall come, and I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts. Even in the New Testament, in Luke chapter 1, we find that Zacharias the priest, the father of John the Baptist, or who would be the father of John the Baptist, he prophesied about his future son and about the coming Messiah when he said in Luke chapter 1 and 76, he said, "And thou, child," talking about John, "shall be called the prophet of the highest, for thou shalt go before the face of the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation unto his people by the remission of their sins, through the tender mercy of God, whereby the day spring from on high hath visited us." That's talking about the Messiah right there. He's the day spring from on high. "To give light to them that sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace." So today, as we sing this familiar song, O come, Emmanuel, I want us here at CFPC on December 13th, 2020, to understand something. Today, we are not just looking to the past and celebrating what the Lord did for us in the past, but here at the end of the year 2020, we are also looking forward to the future. Just as Israel longed for the first coming of the Messiah, today we, as the church, we should be longing and looking for his second coming. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. Jesus Christ speaks to us in the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verses 16 and 17. And he says to us, "I, Jesus, have sent mine angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, and the bright and morning star, and the Spirit and the bride say, come. And let him that heareth say, come. And let him that is athirst come. And whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely." So if you're here today and you're thirsty for something more than what this world has to offer, we present to you today the ultimate solution. He was not only the Savior of Israel, but of the entire world. Church, today as we sing, O come Emmanuel, let's take this ancient hymn and make it our modern day prayer. We are celebrating the birth of Jesus, but at the same time, we're telling him we want him to return, to come back. As we sing today, let's make this personal and echo the words found also in the book of Revelation 22 and verse 20, where it says, "Even so, come, Lord Jesus. O come, Emmanuel."
Disperse the gloomy dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice.
When the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary, he first describes her as highly favored and blessed among women. The Lord is with you, he tells her. This greeting leaves her troubled, confused, disturbed. She casts in her mind or tries to figure out what kind of salutation this should be. She learns that she will bear a son and his name is Jesus. Without argument or question, she replies, I'm the Lord's servant. May everything you said about me come true. According to Luke chapter 1, in what has been called Mary's song of praise, she trusts the Lord, praising him, saying, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit has rejoiced in God, my Savior. For he has regarded the lowly state of his maidservant. For behold, henceforth all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him from generation to generation. Pregnancy and motherhood require selflessness. Mary knew that her selflessness would propel the prophecy of our Savior being born to give the world salvation. Mary had been given a huge responsibility, but she chose to believe the Lord. And through that, received a blessing. In Luke chapter 2, on the night of Jesus' birth, shepherds came to see him after a visit from a host of angels declaring that the Savior was born. Verse 16 states, and they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Mary may not have known at that moment what all Jesus would accomplish here on earth, but she remembered the angel telling her in Luke 1:37, "For with God nothing is impossible." She knew the promises of God to be true. He is mighty. He is holy. He has come to save us. This next song lists miracles that Mary would see later. The blind will see. The deaf will hear. The dead will live again. The lame will leap. the dumb will speak the praises of the Lamb. The little baby she held in her arms was more than just a child. He was the great I Am. Amen.
Prophet Isaiah spoke the words that are recorded in Isaiah chapter 9, verses 6 through 7. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. These words were then echoed by the angel of the Lord to shepherds on the day of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. The very Prince of Peace, who makes heaven his throne and earth his footstool, now made his throne a humble manger. Simple shepherds came to worship and adore him at his birth, just as the angel foretold. While worshiped by few at his birth, as he made his way to Jerusalem for the final time before his crucifixion, Matthew 21 verses 8 through 9 tells us that a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strawed them in the way. And the multitudes that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, representing praise, worthy of only the Prince of Peace, the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ.
The Savior came to a world that was broken, good news to all mankind. In him the fullness and hope of salvation, he led the way to life.
Let peace be in our hearts tonight. Hallelujah, oh holy night. Angels sing on this night divine. Hallelujah, oh holy night. Let peace come down and shine heaven's light. Let peace come down and shine heaven's light. Whoa, 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 shine heaven's light.
All who are weary, all who are burdened, come lay your worries down. He will restore the heart that is hurting. Come join in heaven's sound.
Let peace be in our hearts tonight. Hallelujah, oh holy night.
Angels sing on this night divine.
Hallelujah, oh holy night. Let peace come down. Whoa, 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 shine heaven.
sing on this night divine.
Alleluia, O holy night. Let peace come down and shine heaven's light.
Alleluia, O holy night. Angels sing as our praises rise.
Alleluia, O holy night.
Jesus, you reign in our hearts tonight.
Jesus, you reign.
This next song is called It Came to Pass. And I just want to talk about, everybody knows that God died for us, right? That's what everybody always thinks about. They always think about God died for us. He went on the cross and he bled for us. He died for us. But what was much harder than that one decision to me is he lived for us. A perfect, untouched God wrapped himself in flesh, came down, and was born for me. He had to learn how to walk, to speak, to understand, to comprehend. That body had to learn that. He grew. He dealt with all the troubles that we deal with, all the temptations to every extent. He dealt with every temptation that we have dealt with. The worst person in here, he dealt with every temptation that you dealt with. He felt it. All knowing that he would eventually come to the day where he would die for us. He did all of that, years, developed connections with his family and died so that we may be saved. That's a master's plan right there. That is a master's plan. He's an intentional God and he lived for us.
Past, a child was conceived, a virgin girl betrothed in Galilee. The angel came, revealed the ancient plan. A baby boy, Christ the Son of Man. Though she could not comprehend such a mystery, just a glimpse of you revealed was compelling her to sing. Son of God, a stable for a bed. A helpless child wrapped in ragged cloth. His parents praise a simple gift of all. Though they could not comprehend such a mystery, just a glimpse of you revealed was compelling them to see. was lit to show the way. The wise men came to worship Christ the babe.
This is our God, a great and humble King. All glory to the Lord, the firstborn majesty.
Look, I know we've been singing this song, and I hope everybody has enjoyed this so far. But as we continue on to this next song, as we continue singing, I'm inviting everyone in this room not just to sit here and come into this place as a performance, okay? Because what we've been doing, we've been practicing for this for a little while. But we've been putting worship in it. So these aren't just words that we sing. These aren't just words that we just say that we've rehearsed over and over again. But we are going to sing a song called Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb that was slain. From the foundation of the world, it says that he was slain. Now this Lamb, it tells us in Isaiah that he was beaten beyond recognition, that he was beaten beyond what anybody, any man had ever endured. And because he was beaten like this, now the Lamb in the Old Testament Passover, it was not beaten like this. This thing was taken care of. He was brought in as one of the family. He was taken care of and held dear to the family. And they took this Passover Lamb's life. Now our Jesus, our Savior, this Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world, it had to have no spot, no blemish, no wrinkle. And yet all of us put a blemish on him as he was offered, as he was put on a cross. Now, Revelation tells us that the elders and the beasts, they gathered around singing, glory to the Lamb, glory to the Lamb. He is worthy of it. So worship with us, worship with the choir as we sing, glory to the Lamb.
Church.
Forever. Hallelujah.
Father, we sing glory. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Musicians, keep playing for just a moment. We're not done yet. Hallelujah. Right now, the waters are troubled. If you need a miracle in your life, I encourage you just to lift your voice, lift your praise to the Lord right now, and let's give glory to the Lamb. If you're able to, I'm asking you to stand all across the house as you're unifying with the body, as an act of reverence to Jesus Christ. If you know Him and you believe in Him, stand, and you're able to. If you're able to do so, let's stand and give Him honor today. Come on, musicians, keep playing. Right now, we're not going to sing. We're just going to take a moment and give Him honor. Give Him reverence. Come on, you that have been saved. You that have been saved from sin. You that were on your way to a devil's hell and you know it. And you know Jesus stepped in. Jesus stepped in and stopped you while you were on the path that you were on. He gave you hope. He gave you life. He gave you resurrection. Would you just give Him thanks for it right now? Because He is the Lamb. He died so that you and I would live. He died so that we don't have to be bound by sin and addiction. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, come on. We're not in a hurry to move on. He deserves everything that we can give Him right now. He deserves everything that we can give Him right now. Come on, every praise that's in your heart, why don't you just let it out to Him right now? He wants to hear your voice. This choir's been singing beautifully, but now it's your turn. He wants to hear your voice lifted in praise and worship as you give glory to the Lamb. Oh, I love you, Jesus. Oh, I worship you, Lord. You've been so good to me. You're the King of Kings. You're the Lord of Lords. You're my Prince of Peace. It's not just a scripture, Lord, but you've been the Prince of Peace in my life. You give peace like nobody else can give. Lord, you do things that nothing else can do for me. You're my Savior, my healer, my Redeemer, my friend. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I worship you, Lord. I worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Sing, Lord, to the Lamb. You just say, glory to the Lamb. Say, glory to the Lamb. We give all glory to the Lamb. Could you sing it? Just give it to Him. Glory to the Lamb. Lord, we give You glory to the Lamb. We give all glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. One more time, say glory. Glory to the Lamb. That's why we're here, to give glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. We give all glory to the Lamb. Come on, church, worship Him one more time. We love You, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the living God is in this room right now. That same Jesus that was born of a virgin 2,000 years ago, He ascended later after He was crucified, buried, and He rose again. Then He ascended, but He came back a few days later on the day of Pentecost. He came as the Comforter, which we call the Holy Ghost. And if you don't have that gift of the Holy Ghost, the gift of the Holy Spirit in your life, you can receive it today. If you've had it, But it's been a while since you've connected with the Lord, and you just need to be renewed in the Spirit. You can have that today before you leave. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to sing one more song. Just one more song. And as we sing, I want you to know these altars are open. If you haven't come yet and you would like to, these altars are open. This is a song that Sister Vivian wrote. And as you continue to pray, I'm going to ask her to come and just say something. We're not done yet. We're not done yet. But we've got one more song. Sister Vivian wrote this. It says, "From the manger to the cross, the greatest love story of all." And there's a part we get to in the middle that says, "Free from guilt and shame, all because you came, grace and mercy flow. My life is made whole." And as we sing today, if you need to be delivered from anything, whatever you need, that grace and mercy, that guilt and shame that you need to be removed and replaced with the grace and mercy of God, you can have that today. So as we sing, these altars are open. Church, let's pray one for another. If you need to be dismissed at any time, you can. But let's spend the last few minutes of this service just praying together, and let's let God have His way. The greatest love story of all.
Isaiah 9 and 6 says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. He is all those things to me and more. He loved me when I was not worthy of love. He forgave me when I was not worthy to be forgiven." I was thinking about the song earlier that said, "If you had known me before I knew him." He was born in a manger. He was wrapped in swaddling clothes. But that is only the beginning of the story told. He went from the manger to the cross. He gave his life on the cross for me and for you. What love he has given to us. He came and he carried it all. In my time of crisis, he's my counselor. When I am in a storm, he is my peace. And when I need to be held, he is my father. I no longer carry guilt. I no longer bear shame. I am covered by grace and mercy. I find in him everything I need. From the manger to the cross, the greatest love story of all.
Love so strong, baby. thankful.
Oh, because you came, grace and mercy flow, my life is made whole.
Come on, sing free.
Free from guilt and shame. Oh, because you came, grace and mercy flow, now my life is made whole.
One more time.
Free from guilt and shame. Oh, because you came, grace and mercy flow, now my life is made whole.
I will bless the name.
Bless the name of Jesus.
I will bless the name.
Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus.
I will bless.
Come on, let's do it together.
We bless the name of Jesus.
With all your heart,
bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus.
I will bless the name.
Bless the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I will bless the name.
One more time.
Bless the name of Jesus.
There's no better
bless
like you,
the
church, let's worship.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, he did that for you. He did that for me. No matter what life has taken you through or to, or where you're at today, he knew you was going to be where you are. But he said, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to be born into a world so I can be the Savior of a world, to a world, for a world. He probably looked down in time and thought, I can't believe that's where that Hunt boy is going to be. But I'm going to go ahead and lay my life down anyway. And he gave it for us. You know why he did it? That you and I can live and have life more abundantly. Where we're at right now is not all it is to life. Being in the spotlight is not all it is to life. Having fun for a moment is not all it is in life. My friend, I'm here to tell you, my God said he'll give you life, and he'll give you life more abundantly. I thank God that we have a God that way today. How about you, brothers and sisters? Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Can we all stand all across the building? I feel the Holy Ghost to pray over you today before you leave. I don't know. Maybe you want to come, and if you want to give your life to God, I'm not going to leave this place if somebody's saying, you know what? I just want to give my life to God. If you're here today and you're ready to change things around in your life, the best thing you can do for Christmas is give your life to God right now. Maybe you want to recommit some things to God. This ain't first of the year, Brother Hunt. I don't care. It's a good time. Today is the day of salvation. Maybe it's you, sir. Maybe it's you, ma'am. Maybe you're struggling with an issue in your mind or heart. But as we pray today together, I want you to pray right where you're standing. If you want to come to this altar, it is open. But I want you to pray right where you're standing. Search me, God. Search my heart, oh God. Create a clean heart in me, oh God. Renew a right spirit in me, oh God. Let me lose that spirit of whatever may be coming against me, God. I need you today. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, would you pray with me? The altar's open if you want to pray here or pray from your seat. But God's fixing to move in your life. He's going to change some things. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I pray all across this place. I pray your spirit, Lord, is about to anoint lives. It's going to change hearts right now. As they're calling out for mercy, oh God, would you pour your mercy, your love, your kindness, your joy into their heart, strength into their bodies where they need it today. God, you hear their cry today. Is there anyone who wants to step out and say, God, I want to repent to you today. I want my heart changed today. Is there anyone who want to come to this altar and say, God, I just want you to know I love you. I just want you to know I care, Lord. Thank you for being a God to me, Jesus. Come on, whoever you are, if you have a need, would you come? God's going to touch your need today in your life. He's going to touch where you are right now. Come on, just say, God, here I am again. Can I tell you, sir, God loves you. Ma'am, God loves you. In spite of any issue you may have, God loves you right now. Come on, let's believe together right now for our sisters in the name of Jesus. Let the Holy Ghost touch what they need today. Come on, is there another one? Come in the name of Jesus. Touch the needs that are here today. In the name of Jesus. Come on, you don't have to go with your need anymore. You can leave with it met today in the name of Jesus.
My life is faithful.
Oh, yes it is. He can make your life whole.
Shame. All because you came.
Because he came, we can have it
grace
today. Come on, let God bless you. Make sure your heart comes. An election is sure today.
Whole.
Let it be made whole. Yes, sing it quietly.
Free from guilt.
Oh, I want to be free from that.
All because you came.
Oh, because he came.
Grace and
mercy. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I praise you.
Now my life is made whole.
Jesus. All you have to do is surrender.
Came.
We bless the name that is above every name. Jesus, hallowed is thy name.
Name of Jesus.
You are great and great to be praised.
Bless the name of Jesus.
Oh, we bless your name.
Bless the name of Jesus.
Bless the name. Hallelujah. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Come on, let's give the choir a hand clap today. What an awesome God. Thank you guys for following after the Spirit of the Lord. Come on, God can touch our lives at any time. I'm thankful to celebrate this season today. Hey, you don't want to miss Wednesday night. I know Wednesday night is hard to do sometimes because of work, but it's worth the sacrifice. It's worth to walk in here in your work clothes if you have to. It makes your week go better. It gives you extra strength. It encourages you. Try to be back Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. Don't forget about tonight. If you are a man, make sure you stop by the table. Get your ticket. We're going to tear off tickets and give it to you for the banquet tonight. Be here at 6:30. Make sure you show up. We have plenty of food. We're going to have a good time, but you have to bring an old necktie off of your rack and an old tube out of your tube box. We're going to have fun with that tonight. God bless you. We love you. Got an announcement over here. All right, children's church party Wednesday night. But if your kid has maybe left a jacket, make sure you get it, because Goodwill will get it in about 2 weeks if you leave here too long. So make sure you go get your kids' clothes. God bless you. We love you. If you're going out of town next week, Merry Christmas. But make sure you're here if you're not out of town. We're going to have church, and a Christmas sermon will be next Sunday. God bless.